Clinton gives Tim Kaine's debate a thumbs up. Donald Trump says his guy won the night. Shocker of all shockers. But what did either performance win over voters? Let's bring in the panel. Let's talk about it. Jim Messina is here. He's the CEO of the Messina Group. President Obama's 2012 campaign manager. Joseph Borelli, New York City councilman and a Donald Trump supporter. Doug Heye is here, CNN political commentator and the former communications director for the Republican National Committee. And Manu, Raju, CNN political reporter, senior political reporter, and all-around great guy.
Yeah, thank you, Kate.
That sets you up for a really tough question.
Yeah, that's right.
So about last night. Doug Heye, you have no love for Donald Trump. You are a tried-and-true Republican, however. The poll said that Mike Pence won. What did you see? Is that what you saw?
I think both vice presidential candidates did what they wanted to do.
Did their job.
Yeah, absolutely. Look, Mike Pence wanted to be a steady hand for a campaign that doesn't have necessarily a steady hand at the top of the ticket. Tim Kaine wanted to make sure that we heard a litany of everything that Donald Trump has said and done over the past year. I think they both succeeded at what they wanted to do.
If you take the poll and you take Donald Trump's word for it, you know, Mike Pence won it. If this is a loss for Tim Kaine in any way, if he came off, as Jeff Zeleny said, he came off too hot, he came off too aggressive, where Mike Pence is kind of a cool cucumber and he's kind of used to that conversation. Where did Tim Kaine go wrong, do you think, if he did?
Look, I agree with my brother up there. I think they both did exactly what they were supposed to do.
Yeah.
They were supposed to go in there and help their bosses. And let's be very clear, the vice presidential debate will not move this election at all.
Don't tell the poor VPs. I always feel so bad.
It's not going to matter. That said, Tim Kaine did exactly what he was supposed to do. He was supposed to wail away on Donald Trump, and that's what he did, and I was really proud of him.
I have a sneaky suspicion you really hope that last night means a whole lot to this race.
Well, unlike Jim, you know, I'm kidding, I was going to say your resume, I don't know if you've been around campaigns enough.
Right. Exactly. Sadly, I have.
Right.
No,
you will not exploit your youth and
right.
experience.
I have the PTSD to prove it, I guess.
Exactly.
Donald Trump would say I'm weak.
One of the things that the Trump campaign was trying to do, and they accomplished it, was to change the narrative from an otherwise shaky week. And I think that was accomplished. I think Tim Kaine came off as fundamentally unlikable. He sort of came off as like that know-it-all dinner guest you don't really want to sit next to, who doesn't get invited back the next time. I think that's not a good place to be with the American public. I don't think he attracted any new voters. I don't think maybe Pence brought any new voters on board our side as well. But ultimately, I think it changed the narrative.
That must be why I'm never invited back to dinner parties. I'm just interrupting everybody from one point.
Pulling a cane.
I'm pulling a cane. It's now been a verb. Here's the thing. Two things happened with Mike Pence that I just have to discuss. First of all, he was asked direct questions, and he artfully deflected and just dismissed and went on. He even said, I'll answer that, and absolutely did not answer it. And then he started to basically tell us that up is down is up, and black is white, because he denied that Trump said, and he has said things that are on camera, has said in the past. How is that a win? Does that not matter to anyone?
Well, it does matter in the narrative going forward, and it's given ammunition for the Clinton camp, clearly, going forward. But Mike Pence had a goal going in. He did not want to get into a tit for tat, particularly on a lot of the more controversial things that Donald Trump said.
Right.
At one point last night, Tim Kaine said that he hasn't even responded to the accusations about the attacks over Miss Universe, calling Judge Curiel, criticizing him because of his Mexican-American heritage. Mike Pence probably had an opportunity to interject himself at that point, decided not to, clearly didn't want to get into that level of argument. But also by his comments on, say, on talking about Trump's position on nuclear policy, nuclear proliferation, immigration, whether or not to punish women who have had abortions, Trump has been on both sides of the issues on those particular issues. So it's very hard for a vice presidential candidate to exert himself or explain where the top of the ticket is.
So
when the top of the ticket's
right.
not clear where he is.
Well,
that's why I think he didn't help Trump last night, right? For exactly that point. He didn't defend Trump on immigration, didn't defend Trump on the Muslim comment. He didn't defend Trump on a whole bunch of issues. What he did, I think, very effectively last night was announce his campaign for presidency in 2020. Right? I think that's what happened last night.
Yeah. He's had his eye on it.
Right, you saw him walk away from Donald Trump's position over and over and over again. And the big winner last night was Pence for Pence, not Pence for Trump.
Did you have a little tear? This is what could have been.
I've had big tears for about a year and a half now. But look, let's go back to 1988 when Lloyd Benson decimated Dan Quayle in the vice presidential debate. It didn't matter going into November.
And that's
what we have to remember with these things. It's great to talk about and who was up and who was down and day as night and so forth, but it ultimately really doesn't impact voters.
So let's talk about then the very important debate coming up on Sunday. It's a town hall format. We have Anderson Cooper and Martha Raddatz of ABC. They are moderating, but this town hall format is fascinating. You have both campaigns saying this is great for our guy and gal. Listen to this.
He has gotten very excited about the format. The town hall format is really a sweet spot for him because he's the one out there with voters every single day.
She's very used to the format. She likes it. She likes answering questions from individual citizens that, you know, she listens hard and relates to people.
They both can't have advantage. I'm not letting people get away with
whatever
this.
Whatever happened to lowering expectations?
That's what I was saying. This is Kellyanne Conway. This is antithetical to what she did in the first debate. This is where Donald Trump has an advantage. That is definitely not what they said in the first debate. First debate was like, if he walks on the stage and doesn't throw up, he wins.
Well, look, I don't know if you could judge this maybe objectively, but if you look at the commander-in-chief forum a couple of weeks, I think it was pretty commonly heard that Donald Trump did better than Hillary Clinton, and Donald Trump did better in that performance than he did in his first formal debate against Clinton. So I think it is a better format, and if Hillary Clinton tries to sort of interrupt and shut down substantive conversations mm-hmm. a la Kane, the way Kane did, I think she'll look bad if she's doing that against audience questioners rather than a moderator.
Do you think Clinton has a leg up?
I'm not sure we were going to need to worry about Hillary Clinton interrupting during this debate. I think that's going to be Trump's big challenge, right? He wants to get every single point in.
Right, that was the problem in the first debate. It was all Trump interruption.
That's exactly right. And so I think that's his challenge in this next debate. I think the other problem is Pence sort of set Trump up a little bit, right? You all are saying how great he was in contrast to Trump. Trump now needs to have a big night. He's behind in the polls. He says, his own campaign manager says, this is his format. He's ready. I agree mm-hmm. with you. This was supposed to be his other format, but maybe second time's a chance. He's got to have a big night, and that sets him up in a very difficult way for him to reach those expectations.
And the stakes, of course, are huge because this race is still very tight.
It's still very tight.
Even if Hillary Clinton won that first debate, battleground states, he's still 4 or 5 point race, and it could swing back very quickly if he has a big night, because this is a race about momentum.
And importantly, this is when early voting is happening. So
that's
this might
exactly
be the
right.
last word that people get if they haven't already voted.